So in this diagram we have seen red riser and down comer. If you go to the next diagram, let us go to this one. This is called as hydrant. Okay, from there water is collected. This is called as dry riser. Dry riser means water is not there. Okay, water is not there. Can you understand easily? Okay, here dry rising means what is happening here? Rising means water is pumped from the bottom. That is understood. Dry rising means initially it is dry. During fire, the what this van will come and will pump the water. Will pump the water to this pipe so the fire extinguisher persons can collect the valve, can collect the water from each this thing. So these are called as landing valves. This is called as firefighting shaft. This is called as a firefighting shaft. This is again air vent. Okay. So similarly, breaching inlet is there. From there, it is connected to this vehicle. From there, water is taken inside. So this is called as dry riser. So it is called as hydrant. It's called as a hydrant. So in this one, wet riser come down comer system, we have dry riser. It is a vertical pipe which is always kept dry to avoid what? Freezing of water. Hydrant, it is a horizontal pipeline without outlet of 63 mm dia connected to underground water tank. That's all, underground water tank. Okay. So now water tank, what about the capacity? Here we have underground as well as terrace water tank. So capacity. So underground water storage tank varies from 50,000 liters to 250,000 depending upon the type of building, occupancy of the building. So 50,000 to 250,000. So the capacity of terrace level water storage tank may be 10,000 liters to 20,000 liters. Okay. So depending upon that, we are providing the tank capacity. Okay, water tanks. Fire detection system. This is explained in 7.9 part 4 NBC or else 8 of appendix A. So fire detection means whenever there is a fire, there will be some sensors. They will catch the fire signals and that signal is sent to the control board. From there, persons will be knowing where the fire has occurred. Okay. Or you can have smoke detectors, temperature detectors, sensors. All these are called as a fire detection system. From there, signal is sent to central. Okay. So now we can understand here. Different types of detectors are provided as per the risk involved. Okay, detectors are different types. Zones are made as per the risk or as per the floor. Okay, again zones are made. Maybe kitchen, we have more sensors, maybe high priority zone. For bedroom, lower sensor, like that. Okay, two-way communication system to be provided which will help to contact from the ground floor to the specific floor. Okay, two-way communication. Two-way communication system shall also be provided. Okay, so now mic on every system has also been provided. Manual call points, automatic detector, public address system shall also be interlinked. Detector shall be installed as per IS 2189. Okay, so that is the clauses regarding detection system. If you see this diagram, you will understand. Fire detection system, these are what? External alarm. These are called as external alarm. So here we have circuits. Here zonings have been done. Zone 1, zone 2, zone 3. See, these are called as internal alarms. Means wherever the premises are there, buildings are there. Okay. These are called as detectors. Continuous detectors are there. So they will detect the smoke and fire. So here that is the control panel is there. Big control panel. These are the buildings. Buildings are the part of the buildings where continuous detectors are monitored. So here is another room. There the circuit is there. Detectors are there. Detectors are there. If any part of the building catches fire, so then it will send the signal to the control panel. Okay. From there, they are again communicating back to this one through the fire system. Okay. So here it is a fire detection system. Sprinkler system. It is explained in part 4 of NBC. Sprinkler system is must for basement parking and other risk areas where large quantity of combustible materials are stored. So wherever you are storing combustible material, so you have to have sprinkler system. So each sprinkler should cover approximately 6.96 square meter area. Okay. So normally a separate sprinkler should be provided for a separate car. So for every car should provide a separate sprinkler. Sprinklers may connect to main water tank, it is also there. Pump, but capacity of the tank and pump shall be increased in the proportionate. Means what? Building plus parking. So you need to some increase in the water tank capacity. The capacity of the water tank shall be calculated on the basis of sprinklers. On the basis of sprinklers. Okay. So it's a typical example of a sprinkler system where continuous arrangement of pipes have been made, through that water is sprinkled. This is the actual photograph of the sprinkler system where we are saying this one. Okay. Escape route. So can you see this one? Like this. This is a plan. So this type of drawings have been commonly posted on the walls of all corridors, all passageways. Okay. So in case of emergency, fire emergency, by referring this drawing, they will understand which is the path to get to the exit square route, exit staircase or escape route. Okay. So as per the section, this 8.2.5 of part 4 of NBC, the escape route should be marked with the signboard. Means what? It should be present on each and every board, corridor, passage, to guide the evacuation, to guide the evacuation. Normally, the escape route sign board must be written in a luminous paint, means at the night also it should be visible for easy identification. This is a guide every occupant of the building who is bound to panic in the event of accident. If anyone scared, getting scared, but after seeing this one, they will understand which path they should follow. Okay. Alternate power supply. As per the D, Appendix D 1.5 of Part 4 NBC, a standby generator should be installed. A standby generator should be installed to supply power for staircase lighting, to supply power for staircase lighting, corridor lighting, fire pump, okay, pressurization fan, blowers in the event of disconnection of failure of from main supply. If the KB person will disconnect this one, so you should have some alternate power supply which should supply to staircase lighting, corridor lighting, fire pump and pressurization fan. Okay. Fire alarm system, what it includes? In the conventional fire alarm system, conventional fire alarm system and its components are wired to the same cable. Okay. So in the conventional, all the wirings have been done to the same cable that connects them to fire alarm control panel. Okay. When a component is activated, a signal is displayed on the control panel. These type of systems are inexpensive, work well in small facilities. Okay. So the main problem with this conventional fire alarm system is that when fire alarm component produces a signal and it appears on the control panel, there is no way to know which component it is in the building. If you see this diagram, you will understand. Okay, what it is telling? If you foresee this problem, you may want to consider addressable fire alarm. So there are two cases: conventional fire alarm, addressable fire alarm. Okay, if you see this diagram, you will understand this one. What is that? Conventional. So this is the control panel. Okay, this is a, sorry, what is that? This is a control panel. So all the rooms, all the parts of the buildings are connected by one wire or one cable. Okay, one single cable which runs throughout. So if any problem happens, that part will send a signal to this. These people will understand that there is some fire problem, but they are not able to understand in which part the fire is taking place. Similarly for this also, because only one wire is running, no? So that is why they will understand some fire problem has occurred, but they will not be understanding which part is under fire. See, that is what we have explained here. Okay. If you go for this addressable fire alarm, means what? Separate circuits will be there. Okay. So this addressable fire alarm system are the most modern type of system, and its components have individual unique identifiers. Means they have individual unique identifiers. When one of the system component is initiated, it indicates the component address on the file alarm panel. Means what? The blinking of light which may be start takes place in the control panel, and they will be understanding, okay, in this part of the building there is a fire, like that. Okay, large facilities are typically equipped with these systems. Large facility, okay, large buildings, large factories, because they can quickly pinpoint where the trouble signal originated, from which part the signal is come. Okay, so now this saves a lot of time because it eliminates the need to search for the component that has produced the signal. So once some person will be knowing, no, so in this part of the building, okay, you go there, you check there whether fire is there or not, because we have obtained the signal. Okay, like that, addressable. So previous case was conventional. Okay, you can see separate signals, separate circuits. Okay, separate circuits. Okay, they have a control panel, one light up occupies. Okay, from this detector we have got the signal. Okay, go there. Okay, similarly if you got signal there, okay, go there. Like that, addressable can be easily achieved. Okay.